Colors in SwiftUI can be tricky to use because they require careful handling to ensure consistency across different devices, light and dark modes, and dynamic accessibility settings. Without a clear understanding, it's easy to run into issues like unexpected color changes or misaligned design elements. In this video, we'll demystify SwiftUI colors and guide you through everything you need to know, from creating adaptive colors and using asset catalogs to managing custom color schemes effectively. By the end, you'll have the confidence to use colors seamlessly in any SwiftUI project. Check out the link in the description for my Christmas sale. Now, today I'm going to talk about colors in SwiftUI. Here I have just a simple scroll view, so you know we can just take a look at all the colors that I'm going to talk about here, and that's our starter project. So how do you actually use a color in SwiftUI? Well, you could just use the color view view right over here, color dot, and as you can see, there are some predefined ones. You can use black, red, blue, yellow, white, and so forth. Let's just go with green. There we go. And of course, now we're just going to have a single line because we are inside the scroll view. Let's have a frame added to it. So frame with a height of, let's go 70. So there we go. We have a simple color, and it couldn't get much easier to just add a simple color in SwiftUI. Now remember, colors are also views. They behave exactly the same as views do. Colors are pushout views. They try to expand as much as they can, take up as much space as they can. Okay, so that's a simple color of green. Now there's also an accent color. So let's just go with color.accentColor. And yeah, let's just have the frame also. And as you can see, it's set to blue by default, which is, you know, the system color for any iOS, you know, standard accent color. Now, you could change the accent color by just going into your colors assets right over here. If you are starting off as a new project, you will have your accent color right over here. Please delete it because you need to create your own. Let's create a new color set and type it, give it the name accent color, just like that. It has to be named accent color. And then let's just grab both of these and let's just select some random accent color right over here. Let's just go with maybe grape. That would be fine. Okay, so now if I come back right over here and let's have some more space, the accent color will not be that default blue. It will be this grape color, which is really amazing, just having this accent color all available inside your app. Of course, you may choose to give any default color for your accent color. This is a nice way of grabbing your accent color. Now, and of course, if you don't set any color, buttons, all of those things that do have accent color will use your set accent color. This Christmas, give yourself the gift of faster, smarter app development with my ultimate bundle for iOS developers who code in SwiftUI. For a limited time, get all my products plus the flagship SwiftUI Camp, a four-week virtual bootcamp starting January the 2nd, designed to make you an expert SwiftUI developer. The total value is $2,280, but during this Christmas sale, it's all yours for only $199. That's a massive 91% off. Don't miss this offer of the year. Grab it now. The link is down in the description. So there's another way that we can initialize the color, and that is with the UI color initializer. And as you can see, it requires a UI color. UI colors come from UIKit. And you have some more variables right over here. For example, I like a label. Label is not available inside a SwiftUI. And it's really, really helpful if you want to set up a custom color for your, you know, labels. And this is black, okay, but let's see what happens if I just turn on dark appearance. As you can see, it just turned into white. So this is basically what the dot label UI color is. Okay, let me just remove that. So yeah, you can use any UI color. Of course, you can just use the UI color initializers. Go ahead and do so. Another one is with CG color. So color, maybe you are going to have your CG color, your color variable coming from your server as a CG color. You can just use your CG color just like that. Let's just initialize this with red, green, blue, and alpha. Of course, you may have all of these initializers. Use any of them as you see fit. This seems to be just fine. That's great. And again, let's have a frame right over there. Really nice. Also, you can use another UI color initializer. So just go color and then UI color. And let's just go with a hue, saturation, brightness, and alpha. So we can, I'll just show you this one too. So as you can see, there are a lot of these initializers according to your needs. Alpha, let's just go with 0.5. Alpha means, you know, the actual opacity of your color. Let's set the frame again right over here. Okay, so these are kind of, we already knew all of these from, you know, UI color, CG color. These are more complicated, but maybe you want to have one with a hex color. Usually these are stored as hex, so these are quite rare to just use CG color or maybe hue, saturation, all of that. Most probably you are going to use hex colors for your own custom ones. Now, there isn't built-in hex color initializer, so I'm just going to copy this extension from my notes and paste it right over here. There we go. Please feel free to pause the video and take a look at this, copy it out. And this is going to have a hex color, hex value as a string. So let's just have this right over here. So color. And now we have this hex. Of course, I'm not going to use the white color or the black color right over here. Let me just copy out again from my notes what we have. And again, you don't need to have that hash value at the beginning. Just the simple six value hash color. Okay, so next up is our own custom color that we add to our assets catalog. So let's go back to the asset catalog again. Let's create a new color. Again, color set. And then let's just name this background. There we go. Background. And then I'm going to just select again any, let's just use maybe this mocha will be just fine. Okay, so this would be our background color. As you can see, it's spelled out background. So let's use that inside our code. You just go color and then background, just like that, as a string. And of course, it will just use it. But as you might have already noticed, I don't really like just typing out strings. It's really, you can have a typo anytime. So instead of this, I would recommend just using the built-in color dot, and now you will have one with the background. As you can see, it also has this nice preview, and there it is. Let me just move that out of the way. And there we go. We have this nice custom background color for ourselves. And usually this is what I do. Now, these are the ways that you can just initialize a color. Now, there are subtle things that you may use color for. Therefore, we have something called secondary, tertiary color. And I'm going to add those into a horizontal stack. Now, why would you use all of these? Well, because some of your view elements, you want them to pop up, and some you just want to just blend in, but still have those colors that you use. Usually you want to use this with your accent color. I'm just going to use the one with a teal. So let's just have a rectangle. There we go. And then let's just have a foreground for ground style, and then color dot teal. dot foreground style. Just see that. There we go. Okay, horizontal stack. And let's just have a frame on the horizontal stack so we can see it a little bit better. Let's refresh the preview. There we go. We have this nice ethyl. Okay, nothing new just for now. Let me just copy out this and add a few more times. So once, twice, three, four, I believe five times. Okay, so now we have all of these boxes. I believe I added one extra right over here. So you can add something called dot secondary on the actual color. And now, as you can see, it's basically, it has a little bit of opacity. If we are going to switch, and we are going to do that in just a second, to a dark mode, then you will see that actually the background, which we can see now, it's white, it's just going to be black. Okay, and then we have our tertiary. Just wait for that. There we go. And then quaternary, and finally quinary. There we go. And this, with this, you can just simply put any of your UI elements with the effect, you know, how much it should pop up as the color to any of your views. Now, this is really nice. And of course, it comes with the color scheme built in. So if we just switch over there, as you can see, now we are in a dark mode. Let's just go and pop light appearance. Really, really nice. Now, if you do like these types of videos, go ahead and check out my Christmas sale. The link is down in the description.